A lot of people get into music as a hobby and then they start playing, but their interests are in other places, or what I've seen is a lot of people give up too because it doesn't happen in their time. And for us, it was just basically the thought of doing anything else was just unacceptable, you know. I mean, we've had blue collar jobs and stuff like that, and playing guitar is much more satisfying. Jumping on a bandwagon and doing what was popular, we chose to go a route to where that we could identify with, and that I think in the long run, you know, we're going to be a band that's going to be here 20 years from now. But I like to write songs that have we were talking about earlier, metaphors, so that the listener can get their own interpretation and emotions from it. You know, I mean, I know what ball and chain means to me, but I mean, to some people, it means something entirely different. And they come up to me, "Hey, that song's about getting married, isn't it? The ball and chain, you know, my wife." I go, "Not really, but if it works for you, that's cool." And stuff like that, and then heard the Clash and the Sex Pistols, you know, through the years, we started getting more in touch with, yes, our American roots, you know, which was, you know, folk music and traditional country, old blues, and primitive rock and roll, which we saw had very much in common with punk music. The word punk means a beginning. It was a beginning to what's happening now in the music scene. But that was, you know, in the 70s, as far as I'm concerned, not the stereotypes that was occurring in the mid 80s. You know, and that's what we always tried to stay away from, what was trendy and what was popular at the time. I mean, him and I took beatings for walking down, if we wanted to walk down the street where we grew up with a leather jacket, a flat top, jeans, black shoes, and white socks, we better be willing to fight. Bad luck. I don't know, it's a combination of things. It's about like a little bit of defying superstition. It's a little bit about like everyone knows someone in their life who kind of is always having trouble, but it's always someone else's fault. The woe is me type thing, and just always blaming other people when unable to look at themselves. And just kind of, it's just another like hard luck type thing.